and lords, honorable members, Param Pujya Shamaniji, the board of the Institute of Jainavadi, one Jain leaders, ladies and gentlemen. It is an honor and privilege to be here amongst you all this evening. I take this opportunity to introduce one of the oldest organizations looking after management, maintenance, and restoration of Shvetambar Jain temples, namely Anandji Kalyanji Trust, which dates back at least three centuries. The name of the trust is not after anyone, but it means joy and welfare. Anandji Kalyanji Trust is a representative organization of Jain Shvetambar Bhakti Pujak community. This activity was started nearly four centuries back by my 12th ancestor in 16th century, Sher Chandyas. He was the chief jeweler in the royal court of Emperor Jahangir, probably nominated in his early teens. Emperor Jahangir Shahjahan, right up to Aurangzeb. He was a very dynamic and powerful businessman and jeweler who was respected by all. He was appointed Nagar Sheth, chief citizen of the city, by them. This title and position was hereditary till the formation of the Republic of India. During this time, a powerful Jain monk, His Holiness Hirvijayasuri, had his influence in the emperor, and by that virtue persuaded the emperor to give the pilgrimage mountains of Shetrunjay, which is Paratana, Girnar, and Taranja in Gujarat, Samveg Shikharji, that is Parasnath Hill in the state of Jharkhand today, and Mount Tal, the place of world-famous Gilwara temples, to Jain Shvetambar community. In turn, His Holiness Hirvijayasuri gave this ordinances to Sheikh Shantiras, who then became a custodian of his places and temples on behalf of the community. We have various ordinances, which means farmans, issued by these noble emperors with the trust. Akbar, Jahangir, Shahjahan, Murad Bakhsh, and Aurangzeb. The following pilgrimage mountains and places: Shetrunjay, Girnar, Sankeshwar, and Tarangaji in Gujarat, Kesariyaji and Mount Abu in Rajasthan, Parasnath Hill in Jharkhand, and Rajpurhi in Bihar. The Mughal emperors, in time of their own financial difficulties, used to borrow money from Shantiras and his descendants. Looking at the integrity and dynamism of Shantiras and his descendants, the Mughal emperors from time to time renewed the ordinances to them for safety and management of their pilgrimage places. Anandji Kalyanji Trust has assumed a de facto apex position because of the landmark work done by Shantiras and his descendants through this organization. There are several local organizations throughout the country who manage temples in their locality. There is no legal affiliation of this organization with Anandji Kalyanji Trust. However, the entire community looks for direction on several issues, including interaction with the government. The descendants of Sheikh Shantiras were equally dynamic and powerful. They carried on the activities of management and restoration of the temples and contributed a lot to the community and society at large. The activity of management, maintenance, and restoration of the temples was formalized by them into an organization three centuries back. The president of this organization, as per tradition and convention, has to be a direct descendant of Sheikh Shantiras. The following pilgrimage places are managed by Anandji Kalyanji Trust: Palitana, which has over 900 temples itself, houses 14,000 deities, and the trust is managing these temples since 16th century. And the oldest temple on that is 12th century old, with approximately 700,000 pilgrims per annum. Girnar has 17 temples with over 500 deities and managing since 1907. And the oldest temple there is 10th century. Taranga is five temples with around 100 deities, and we manage it since 1921. And the oldest, the main temple is 13th century. Kumbhariaji is again five temples with approximately 200 deities. Trust is managing this since 1921. And the oldest temple there dates back to 11th century. Shirisa is one temple with around 20 deities. Again, the management since 21, and the temple is quite new, dates back to 19th century. Ranakpur and surrounding temples, we have seven temples. A number of deities over 500, and managing it since 1897. And the Ranakpur temple itself dates back to 15th century. Makshi temple is only one temple with 50 deities, managing it again since 21, and the temple is dating back to 18th century. I would like to point out here that Parasnathir, which I mentioned earlier, was bought by my great grandfather Lalbhai Lalbhai from the then ruler of that area more than a century ago. But the temples situated on the mountain are managed by a different trust for over 250 years called the Jain Shwetambar Society. The first constitution of this organization was written and came in force on 19th June 1880. My granduncle, Mr. Kasturbhai Lalbhai, 10th descendant of Shantiras, was a dynamic businessman and a philanthropist. He established textiles and chemicals industry and contributed a lot to the society by establishing the institutes like the Indian Institute of Management, the National Institute of Design, two private universities offering education from kindergarten to PhD courses, and many other scientific, social, and business institutions. The Jain community probably is the largest donor for health and education sector, at least in Gujarat. He presided over the trust for 50 years, and during his tenure of all the restoration works, three particularly stand out. Ranakpur Temple, the Dilwara Temple, though it is under management of another trust, and Taranga Temple. I would like to mention here that he took a British architect, Claude Betty, to Ranakpur and took his eyes on restoration. Mr. Betty designed a beautiful rest house in Indian traditional design and incorporating features of the temple pillars. The design of this rest house is beautiful and timeless. Primarily, the trust is concerned with management, maintenance, and restoration of the temples. As for the Indian culture, the temple has to be intact and therefore needs restoration from time to time. We are very particular to maintain its antiquity and originality, and at the same time make them good for future generations. We engage best sculptors, stone masons and masons for the same. We identify the same quality of stones or material of construction which might have been used to maintain its originality. For example, if a carving is broken, a model from plaster of Paris is made and matched with the rest of the figure. Once the model is perfectly matching rest of the carving or the figurine, the same will be carved out of from the stone, the same sort of stone, and attached to maintain figure by copper fix. World famous Dilwara temples on Mount Abu, Ranakpur, Taranga temples on Mount Girnar, and many others are restored in the same way by this trust. For the temples which are built by bricks and lime mortar, the restoration work is done by scrubbing the walls and pillars by sandpaper. And again, a fine layer of lime is applied to give it a smooth surface. And then they are painted to protect them from moisture. This has to be repeated at least once in 2 decades. Recently, Girnar temples have been restored brilliantly by taking out extra layer of lime which was put on the carved spires, domes and walls to protect them from Mughal invasions. Over the period of last 25 years, that is from 1993 to 2018, the trust has spent approximately equivalent to £8 million for restoration of the temples managed by the trust and given donations in full or part to other trusts up to £24 million for restoration of nearly 1400 temples and £9 million for new temples built in new localities. The trust is always presided by a direct descendant of Shantidas, and including him, there are 9 trustees who have to be from the city of Ahmedabad, and a general body of 130 representatives from all over the country. The trustees meet every fortnight, and the general body meets twice a year to conduct the business of the trust. With all the pride, I can say that all the decisions and reservations so far have been adopted unanimously. The trustees, to their credit, devote substantial time without taking any compensation. I would like to point out that the appointment of the trustees and general body members, including the president, is fully democratic. The local community members in the respective constituencies elect the general body members every 5 years. Similarly, the trustees are appointed or reappointed every 5 years, including the president. The appointment of the trustees have to be ratified by the general body members, including the member of the Shantidas family. I take pride in mentioning that the appointments of the trustees by ratification so far have been unanimous. Very important is that all trustees in the general body of 130 representatives of this trust will bear their own expenses for trust work. Not a single penny is debited to the trust. This holds good for each and every organization of our community. The trust has around 900 employees and around 500 restoration and maintenance staff and workmen. Another important work we do is preservation and restoration of old handwritten manuscripts. And we do give financial support to other libraries who are doing so, or we insist that they do so to preserve these valuable manuscripts. The trust also runs an animal shelter, what we call a pangrapo, for old, sick and disabled animals. And in times of famine, the count goes to as high as 20,000 animals. We continuously make more information available through digital media, creating films, DVDs, etc., and regularly update our website, www.anandjikalyanjipedi.org, to reach out to a wider audience to create awareness of our wonderful heritage. Dear friends, as you can see, over the last 3 centuries, invaluable job of maintaining the most important pilgrimage sites, which is priceless heritage of our very small community. It is an important and complex job that has many sensitivities. It is our endeavor to preserve our places of worship, which are priceless heritage, not only for our community, not only for the country, but probably for the whole world. So it is our endeavor to preserve our places of worship, which are priceless heritage sites for future, that the peoples of the world can admire for centuries to come. I look forward to welcoming you, all of you, to see the sites, and I thank you all for your kind attention and patience.